Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Today I am going to share with you how to make this Asian stir-fried bok choy with quinoa. If you want to see how I make it, stay tuned. I love Asian food, so I had to figure out how to make Asian dishes that will work well with my lifestyle. Everyone always says, how do you eat salads all the time? Well, the answer is that I eat much more than salads. So today I'm going to show you how to make this dish. I love bok choy. And the reason I eat bok choy, other than the fact that I love it, is because it moves excess estrogen out of the body. It's a cruciferous vegetable. Next is garlic. I love garlic. It makes everything taste good. So add as much garlic as you would like. If you don't like garlic, you can just leave it out and replace it with whatever herb or spice you do like. Next is coconut aminos. This is a replacement for soy. If you are struggling with female health issues, you want to stay as far away from soy as you possibly can. The next ingredient is pre-cooked quinoa. This is the only grain that I would suggest you eat if you're struggling with female health issues, and it's really not a grain, it's technically a seed. Now we have our good old faithful onions. I love onions. I put onions in just about everything. So this one is a Vidalia onion. It's a little sweeter, so use whatever variety of onions you'd like to use. First, we're gonna wash our bok choy. Just wash it, just make sure that all the sand and dirt is out before you start to chop it. Now that the bok choy is all nice and clean, we're gonna cut the ends off of the bok choy. And you can cut it any way you would like to, but I like to cut my bok choy lengthwise because I think it looks prettier, it looks more Asian-like, but use your own judgment of how you want to cut your bok choy. I have even cut it into very, very small bite-sized pieces. And actually, I've even shredded it, so you can do whatever you want. Now it's time to slice the onions. You can chop them, you can make them big and chunky. I tried to make the slices as thin as possible. This is about a half of an onion that I'm cutting up here. And just remember, all of the instructions for the recipe for this video will either be in the description box, which I'm going to try and do. Sometimes there's not enough space to write everything. Or there will be a link to a blog post where you will be able to get the full recipe. So don't worry if you can't keep up with the video. Now I'm gonna show you how to cook the dish. First, you start with a skillet. You can use a pot, a skillet, whatever kind of pan you have is good enough. I am using a skillet. This is sort of a non-stick skillet. It's not like the typical non-stick types of skillets that are on the market. It's called Masterclass Premium Cookware. I'll put a link below just so you can take a look at it to see what it's about if you're interested in it. But I'm gonna add the bok choy to my pan, and the pan is heating up. So as it heats up, I'm getting ready to add some water because I water saute my vegetables. A lot of people always ask me, if you can't use oil, then what are you using? Well, in this case, I'm gonna use water. As you can see, it's starting to heat up. You see a little smoke coming up. And I'm just gonna use a wooden spoon to move it around the pan just so that all of the vegetables start to feel some of that heat and start to wilt down and get a little bit soft. But you don't wanna cook this too long because you want the vegetables to actually be crunchy. You see I'm adding water. I added probably about a quarter cup to a half a cup of water. You use your own judgment as to how much you want to use in your dish. You can also use carrot juice, you can use tomato juice, you can use vegetable broth, you can use just about whatever you want in order to saute your vegetables. As you can see, it's starting to cook down a little bit. And also I wanted to say, this serves about 1 to 2 people. It depends on how hungry you are. I ate this by myself because it was for my whole meal and I was hungry. And pretty much I didn't have to eat for the rest of the day. Now I'm gonna add my onions. That's about a half of an onion. You can add more or less, or you can just leave the onions out if you'd like. So I'm just gonna keep on moving the vegetables around the pan until they cook to the consistency in which I want them to cook. Like I said before, I do not want them to be soggy. Next, I'm gonna add my garlic. I love garlic, so I add a lot of garlic. So that's probably about a quarter to a half teaspoon of garlic. You can use fresh garlic if you'd like, or you can leave the garlic out altogether. You can replace it with onion powder if you want. You can use whatever herb or spice you would like. And if I were to do this again, I'd probably use both fresh and regular garlic powder. So, you know, you have your choices. Take your options and explore them. Next, you're gonna add your coconut aminos. You can add 1 to 2 tablespoons for this. And then all you do is just stir it in and let everything get coated with the sauce. This is what's gonna give it the Asian flavor as well. So next you're gonna add your cooked quinoa. That's about a half a cup of cooked quinoa. And the thing about cooked quinoa is I will often make a pot of it, like maybe cook a cup or two at the beginning of the week. I don't eat it every day, but my husband eats it. And so I just make it so that it's on hand, so that in case I want it with a dish. If you are struggling with a lot of female health issues, I would say stay off of the grains. Quinoa is not a grain. It is technically a seed, as we discussed earlier in this video, but I'd still eat it in moderation. I wouldn't be eating it 3 times a day, but it's definitely a much better choice than eating brown rice, amaranth, any of the grains that are considered healthy. I would recommend steering clear of all of those until you're feeling much better. Okay, y'all, there you have it. Asian stir-fried bok choy. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you never miss a video. The full recipe link and the tools I used in this video will be in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching. Talk to you soon. Love y'all.